Hi guys,
I'm Dan. Welcome to PHP tutorial. In this video, we'll learn about arrays in PHP. You use arrays to store multiple values in a single variable. To access an array element, you have an index number. We'll see in a moment what that means. Okay, if you observe, I have an array of telephones, and to display every element of this array, you must use a loop. I will use a for loop. I will begin with 0. And then to see the length of the array, you have a function which is count, and you have the length of the array, how many elements you have in the array, and then increment I. And now let's display each element. To access an element, you must use the index number. Okay, the index number of the array starts with 0. We have 0, 1, 2, and so on. And now let's concatenate a null string. And this is your array. If you see, you have Huawei, Samsung, and the last Huawei. Okay, and now you have some function. If you want to remove an element, okay, use array pop and then the name of the array, and you remove at the end. If you want to remove at the beginning, you use array shift and you remove Samsung this time. If you want to add, you have push telephone, and then if you see, you add at the end with push, and if you want to add at the beginning, you have unshift, and you add at the beginning of the array. If you want to create a string with these arrays, you have a function which is import. With import, you concatenate all of the array elements in one string, and then you must specify how to glue these elements. If you see, I glue with comma. If you want a space, you put space. If you want another symbol, another symbol, and so on. Let's stick with comma. If you see, I have comma and space between elements. And this is how you create a string from these arrays. Okay. And the last thing, let's see if you want the last element of the array. I have the telephone array. And then the last element, if you take count telephone, you have the length of the array, but because you start with 0, you must subtract 1. Okay, and the last element, it's Huawei. For example, if you don't put -1, you have an error, okay, undefined of offset 7, because you have the last offset, the last index is 6. Okay, just bear in mind, because you start with 0. Okay, and the last thing, let's see how you display a multi-dimensional array. If you observe, I have an array of array. Okay. You need two loops. One to loop the lines. I use I for the lines. Count to see the length of each line. And then I have another loop for the columns. I use the index j for the columns. And now, when I have count, I must see the length of each line. If you observe, first line have the length 3, the second line have the length 4, and the third line have the length 2. That means I count what is the length of the each line, because the length of the array is 3, 1, 2, 3, okay? The lines, how many lines you have. And if you observe, you don't have three elements on each line. You have three, four, or two. And then to display this, you must create a string. I create a variable str. Okay. Then to concatenate, use dot. And to access an element, you must specify also the position of the line, also the position of the column. Okay. For example, if you have 0, 0, you access this one, the first element. If you have 0, 2, you have this 4. If you have 1, 1, this is 1, 1. Okay, because this is 0, 0, and this is 1, 1. Okay, and also let's concatenate a break line, okay, to have a space between each lines. And now let's display our string. Okay, something like that. And you display the array. I think this is all for this video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Good.